Can you believe the waves in the river? Tell you what, that's a job and a half. Now, this is a gorgeous migratory brown trout.
I'm gonna give you a nice look at this fish. Look at that. Oh!
Let's go fishing. People, when you're in the mood, let's go fishing. Well, it's just me and you. Head on down to the fishing hole. Grab your hat, get your pole. Let's go fishing. When you're in the mood.
Canadian Sport Fishing is brought to you by Rapala, premium fishing gear crafted from experience. Yamaha, conquer outdoors. Defend products, eco-friendly protection from biting insects. Dickies, quality workwear since 1922.
Gorgeous fall day. We're out here, it's almost the end of November, and we're fishing the mighty Niagara River. And I'm with Aaron Shirley, and we're drifting bottom bouncing along with a lot of other boats. Now, do you think most of these boats are guide boats from New York?
Yep, absolutely, they're all guide boats.
Yeah. So this is kind of neat because I've done this in the winter time. We originally came out here to catch some salmon, and Aaron and I did a bit of pre-fishing on Saturday, and we got some really nice salmon. Aaron got two really big ones. But today the salmon aren't really hitting. So we decided to go to our trout gear, and sure enough, we've got a steelhead on. I hope the net's big enough, Aaron.
Yeah, we got our salmon net here.
We got our salmon net.
Yeah, the salmon fishing was really tough today, yeah. Very tough.
Well, maybe it'll turn on later, I don't know.
I did get a couple hits on lures, but that was it. Been very, very challenging.
Yep.
Trout are a little bit
No, it's
more
a nice steelhead.
Aggressive.
Yeah. You'll see this fish has got gorgeous colors. Yeah, I like that size of net, Aaron. You don't mess around.
So it's hard to mess.
Very gently, get it just underneath the gill plate. So I am gonna do your classic, I was gonna do a grip and grin. Let's see here if I can just hold them. Ah, there.
There you go. Not a bad little steely.
Yeah, and you know what? He really took it. I don't know if I can see that hook. I've gotta put my finger in there, and you know what? They've got lots of teeth. There, oh, perfect. You know, if you get your finger right on the bend of the hook, you can usually pop it right out, and that's exactly what I've done here. So I'm just trying to get that sinker in the boat, Aaron. If you can just hold that line. You might flop out of my hands, but I'm going to give you a nice look at this fish. Look at that. Oh! Did you like that release?
High five. Nice.
Perfect.
Nice. Good release.
Little steely.
All right, Aaron.
Not bad.
Little steely, what do you mean? I don't know if you can bring him over to this side.
I just saw a fish surface right over here. I think it was another steelhead.
You know what? We might want to anchor and try using our center fins over there after.
That would be a lot of fun.
Yep. That's on a sponsack?
Yep.
You can see we've changed the scenery again. We actually came up through an area called the Devil's Hole, and there's quite a few boats to our right and one to our left. It's a little bit out of the wind here because the gorge is narrower. Down below was so difficult to fish.
Oh, it was windy. Yeah. It was bad.
And this is nice. We've only been here about 20 minutes.
Very nice.
And we've got the first steelhead on. Look at nice chrome color.
Yep.
Beautiful. Just take your time.
There you go. Beautiful.
Nice female. Silver fish.
Little guy, but I'll take it.
Yeah.
It's a little scrappy.
I agree.
Especially in the fall.
Yeah, you know right away.
The water's warm still.
When they start head shaking. And I saw that it threw your spawn sack. So you may want to, is it loose?
I don't know,
maybe it ran up the line. There's a beautiful steelhead from the Niagara River. Caught on light line, drift outfit, bottom bouncing. Gonna get it back in the net, and.
Definitely caught before.
Yep, and I'm gonna get it just in the water. And
very
make
nice.
Sure it's got its strength back.
and release it. He will always take time with our fish, even though that's a perfect eating size. I mean, these guys are such great game fish. We just enjoy catching them and letting them go so other fishermen can enjoy them. Come on.
They're
come
such
on.
An amazing fish.
They are.
When you definitely think, been caught before, and that's what that damage is in the gill
plate. I think so. Okay. There. You're free.
Beautiful.
Free to go. Perfect.
Nice.
You know, it's so nice to hook a fish up, eh? Even in these conditions.
Oh yeah, they're quite the conditions, that's for sure. It feels like the middle of winter, like you said.
Well, they were calling for the winds to blow from the north, which is not good on the Niagara River, because that means the wind is pushing the boat into the current, so you can't get a normal drift with the speed of the current. So I'm sure over your years of guiding, you've had to deal with that, and it's very challenging.
Yes, it's one of the most challenging ways to fish the Niagara River, having that wind come up from the north.
Yep. And
yeah, perseverance, and it pays off.
Yep. So this fish, Aaron, I think was in about 25 to 30 feet of water. We haven't seen it yet. I'm using a 100% fluorocarbon line. I know there's a lot of talk in the marketplace, you know, about guys using fluorocarbon leader material and fluorocarbon casting line.
Yep.
This is actually that Suffolk line. You can see it looks white on my spool, but it's clear. And this one is either 8 or 10 pound test. I mean, there's so many rods set up that I'm not sure what I've got. Now, because the fish is getting close to the top, what I'm doing is letting off on the drag just a bit in case he wants to make a run. Because I usually have my drag set a little bit tighter when to hook a fish. And I can't believe this, the fish is under the boat because of this wind.
Yeah.
This is gonna be interesting. I'm gonna try to get it up, unless
watch
I get it on the other side.
The
unless I get it on the other side of the boat. So what I might have to do is go around the electric.
Should be okay, it's coming around again.
Okay, good.
So I haven't even got a look at it yet.
I like using a clear line when we're fishing clear water conditions, and the water has cleared up quite a bit. I was out doing a little bit of pre-fishing yesterday, and there was a couple of foot of visibility or less. I just heard him hit the electric. Oh, I see my weights. You might want to grab the net, Aaron.
Yep.
You know what? I'm going to bring him around to this side because he's going into the wind.
Oh, that's nice brown.
Oh, what a nice brown.
Very nice brown.
Okay. So, are you... Can you believe the waves in the river? Okay, I'm going to stand on one side. Okay, if you want to net it,
yep.
Head first.
Okay,
I'll try
ready?
To bring him over.
Bring him over.
And
got him.
What a goal,
nice
Aaron.
Nice brown.
You know.
Beautiful brown.
A lot of people wouldn't be fishing under these conditions. But
no,
you know
they're,
what?
They're it's, definitely extreme conditions.
It's all worth it. I'm just going to open my bail.
Extreme
and put the
fish,
rod down.
Though. Beautiful.
Yeah,
look at that.
Show
look
you.
The colors on it.
I'm going to kneel down here so I don't lose my footing. And I'm gonna, it doesn't matter if my gloves get wet. Now, this is a gorgeous migratory brown trout. They're a prize for a lot of fishermen to get. And this one is a female. And even though their eggs are very valuable, I know a lot of guys that, you know, would keep this fish to get the eggs. We're gonna be releasing it. Now, if you can get that streamer out of its mouth,
sure,
we're
no
gonna
problem.
Get it in the water. And then we're gonna talk a little bit about the fluorocarbon leader.
Wow, that
water,
was a good hook set.
Was that a good hook set?
Oh yeah.
Okay, you know what, I got gloves on. I'm gonna open his mouth. Can you, take it out reverse. You know, for those of you that love to fly fish, this would be a trophy brown to get fly fishing. Good job. I like the way you hit that off. Okay, so there's a gorgeous brown.
Beautiful.
I'm not
going to
hold it out of the water too long. We're going to get it back in the net, and we're going to release it real quick. Okay, got him back in the net. Tell you what, this is interesting conditions. I want to make sure that fish revives a little bit. It's got tons of energy. I just wanted to get its nice color back. So it's actually tough with this wind, but we're doing okay. We're just gonna keep it in there for a bit because we did have to handle it to get the fly out of its mouth. You know, a lot of people might think that a small fly like that isn't gonna catch fish, but I'll tell you what, a lot of times these browns, they'll still take bait fish because the Niagara River is such a big river. That fish was probably on the bottom in about 25 feet of water, very close to 40, 50 feet. So I got a feeling that they're still feeding, even though they're pretty well ready to spawn. So in just a moment here, I'm gonna let it swim out of the net. I think it's always good to let a fish revive. There it goes. Now Aaron, if you could just pass me that rod, I wanna show the viewers
yeah, sure.
that rig that I had here. Because I think it's kind of important to the distance that you have when you're bottom bouncing like this and what you've got at the end of it. So I got to make sure, you know, with this wind, that I don't leave my gloves on the seat, they might blow in. So thanks, by the way, for getting the fly and rigging it all up here. This is the actual streamer that I was using. And you can see it's white with a little bit of yellow and a little bit of red. But look at the distance from my streamer right here to where I've got my weights. Now, this is a little bit different system. A lot of guys will run a solid weight like you have on,
yep,
on the bottom. I have a couple of split shot because I like the idea that if I do get stuck on the bottom, those split shot will just pull off and I don't lose the whole rig. So I don't have to tie as many knots. But this distance from the three-way down to the streamer is very important. Right now, this is quite short. Aaron's running a longer lead. So that means that this streamer is going very close to the bottom. And this line is extremely important. This is that fluorocarbon leader material that we're talking about. Now, whether it's heavier, like 10 pound or 8, because it's fluorocarbon, it's invisible. And you can see it here. Thanks, Aaron. This is what we're using. You could never use this as a main line. So even though I'm using fluorocarbon as my main line, it's actually called 100% castable fluorocarbon. So very different. This is much stiffer, so it's much more abrasion resistance. That was a nice brown, eh?
Very
big,
nice.
Female. Okay.
Right,
I don't mind fishing in this weather. It doesn't feel so bad when you get a fish on, right?
No, you warm up a little when you get a fish on.
I agree.
Sure.
One of the things that you have to do when you're out here in the Niagara is experiment with different presentations. We've gone from everything to streamers, to using egg sacks, to using some wobbling lures like quickfish. Aaron's got a fish on right now. And as he said, he went back to basics. What color of spawn sack did you put on, Aaron?
I went to a peach roe bag.
Good.
And that's it. You know, we're trying different things because you never know what on any given day what's going to work best. Sometimes, you know, quickfish work extremely well, hot shots. You know, you never know what's going to work. So it's important to have a variety of lures out here.
Aaron, that's a nice rod.
I love it. The North Coast rod is amazing.
That's like the classic Steelhead outfit for the West Coast. That is,
my
favorite. Is that a 9.5 or 10.5?
It's 9.5.
Yeah. No, it's perfect for this kind of fishing.
Oh, yeah. Love
it. Well, you can get some big fish. Even if you were to hook a big Chinook, you could handle it on there.
Oh, yeah.
Or if you get a smaller trout, you can feel everything, you know?
I'm not sure I've ever got a Chinook salmon on it, but I mean, I've gotten fish, you know, like lake trout and stuff up to 20 pounds on it. No problem. Handles it very well.
Okay, when you're fishing here on the Niagara, especially drifting, haven't seen it yet. Oh, yeah. Nice brown. Got it.
Beautiful.
You know, one of the things I was going to say that's really important when you're fishing here in the Niagara, the way we're fishing, is that you keep your presentation within about 3 feet of the bottom. Most of us are bottom bouncing, so we're using either two or three split shots, like I am, large ones, or using a pencil sinker, like the one Aaron's got on. But it's very important because closer to the bottom of the river, there's less current because the current is meeting the rocks that are there. And when you combine a current break, so where there's less current, and also a structure break where it goes from, let's say, 18 to about 25, 30 feet, those are key areas to get beautiful browns just like this one.
Not easy to do sometimes when the wind's like this, that's for sure.
I'm going
to
kneel down again just for safety.
Boat control is critical.
Yep. This is a gorgeous, gorgeous female brown. That's interesting. The other one was a female as well.
Yeah, there are a lot of females in this drift. There's a lot of spawning that takes place in this drift. They're getting ready to spawn soon.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, that's there we go.
Yeah, so hooked very lightly. You might even be able to use that spawn sack again.
Oh, wow. Oh, I almost got the hook in my face.
Oh, you be careful. They've got sharp teeth,
look
too.
Look how that hook went right through.
Very, very gently.
It went right through.
Yeah. Now, we do have pliers, but, you know, these hooks usually pop out pretty easily.
Usually.
Did it go in once or twice? Because it looks
it went right through.
Ah, good hook set.
Yeah, very different.
I can see it. I'm just trying to keep it still. You know what?
Yeah.
Is it sharp, Aaron?
I'm going to just put
it in the net, and I'm going to very gently just hold it. And then we're going to...
He keeps bucking on me every time I go to...
I guess they don't mind the cold weather, eh?
No.
Doesn't help that our hands are a little frozen, right?
No.
We start to lose dexterity. Good call.
I'm just going to bite the line.
What about the spawn sack? You want to keep it?
Back.
Yeah, we're going to show that to the viewers. Oh, come on.
Oh, he doesn't want to give it back.
No,
look at
okay.
that.
So anyway, there's a nice brown trout. I'm guessing that fish is about maybe 4 pounds. So we're going to put it back in a second. But the fishing down here on the Niagara River is excellent for these fish. They start coming up, I'd say, as early as August, September. And they're in here. You can get them pretty well right through till, you know, it gets really cold, like December. So I'm going to get them
all
back.
All winter long, too.
Yeah.
It's a great fishery all winter long.
It's awesome.
Exercise a little bit of caution, though, in the winter.
Oh, yeah,
ice flows,
with ice and everything. So I'm just going to get them over the side over here. And you can see and probably hear that that wind is pretty strong. You know, some of the people keep these fish. You can't eat them. They're great eating, actually. A lot of the fishermen, especially the guides, will get the eggs from them because the eggs are very valuable for bait. But I find using Chinook salmon eggs, oh, it's ready to go. Look at that. Isn't that gorgeous? Come on. Using the Chinook salmon eggs works just as well. I just think these fish are so beautiful, it's nice to release them.
Closed captioning by Petra-Pod, the only trailer that flips into a boat in less than a minute.
Been so strong today that we actually tried to come up to fish another run and we can't get out of the wind. This is funny.
No, the wind's coming right up the river and I don't think there's anywhere to hide today, but yeah. Fish are biting.
It's actually good that we've got the electric. At least we can try to pull the boat into the wind. You know, when you think of the Niagara River, you look at this current, it's really strong. So to figure that the wind is actually pushing us against the current, it's a pretty strong wind.
Very strong.
I'm trying to control this fish. What I did, I changed, instead of using the split shot sinkers that I was using, I just went to a pencil type weight and I went to a quick fish, and you can see I've got a nice trout on. It's right near the surface, right there. It's a good sized fish, Aaron.
Yeah,
I'm trying to keep it from going under the boat. I don't know if you can get the net. I know you're trying to put your outfit away. There's that wind again. Man.
Oh yeah.
It's gusting.
It's relentless today.
We were saying earlier that it's almost more comfortable to be fishing, ice fishing, because you can get in a hut out of the wind than in the open boat. And if I lift this up gently, you'll be able to see that lead that I have off the three-way where I changed to that pencil weight. This fish is really, you know, lake trout are notorious for going down towards the bottom. So I'm trying to keep it up. As soon as we see that three-way, we know that it's close. So just because of the way this current is, it's actually going under the boat. So we're not using the electric right now. There it is. There's the lead, and there's that sinker, and there's a nice lake
trout.
Turn
his head this way.
Yeah, I'm trying to turn his head. Good job, Aaron. You know what? That is a good size fish. Oh, the quick fish just popped out of its mouth.
Yep, there she is.
Beautiful fish. Okay, I'm going to hold it up, and then we're going to release it real quick. I'm just getting that lure back on my rod. This is where I get my gloves all wet. So, you know, you can get a real variety of fish here in the Niagara River. There's a nice lake trout. That fish will probably go about, I'm guessing, 8 to 10 pounds. It's probably about 29, 30 inches long, and it's got tons of energy. So don't want to keep it out too long. You got big heads, eh, and big mouths. They'll take the same baits when you're fishing for the steelhead and browns. You know, so you can get these on single legs. You can get them on spawn sacks. And, of course, some of the wobbly lures, like the quick fish. Okay, I'm going to put it back in the net. And we're going to let it revive over the side of the boat. Maybe I'll take it back here,
yep.
Aaron. And while you control the electric, you know, I want to get out of your way. There. Nice bright tail. You can see how yellow that tail is. I'm trying to hold this fish into the current, but you know what? It's virtually impossible. We didn't have that lake trout out of the water too long, so it should take off if I can get it out of the net. Come on. Fighting the current. There we go. Look it, gorgeous fish, and he just blends in with the bottom. Now, let me show you that quick fish. The quick fish is a very unique lure because it has a side-to-side action. Okay, so flat, and you can see that it doesn't really have a lip, it's the actual head. But when this is going through the water, I'll try to point it towards you, it has this kind of action, back and forth and back and forth. So it's a very good lure to use. And that one treble is all you need on the back of it. I have a fish on, I have no control over it. That's actually a fish, because it's in the main current. So I just gotta be a little bit patient here. See if it stops running line out. Yeah, my trusty net is over here. Just gonna get it out in the open. And come on. Look at that, nice fish. No wonder it felt heavy. It's a good size fish. Nice bend on the rod. Hopefully that leader's intact. It didn't get scraped up on rocks. Just hard to control. Come on. Should be getting tired anytime soon. Come on. Where are you? Keeps diving down. You can see the current on the surface. The current is like going all over the place. There's boils, there's little whirlpools. Come on. If I can just get the head towards the net. Come here. Tell you what. That's a job and a half. And there's that little hot shot set of the fish. So I'm just gonna put that down and show you this fish and release it real quick. There's a nice lake trout. They've got so much energy, you know? And they're so plentiful. I'm trying to pick which side to go on here. I guess this side is as good as any. And it's gonna take off in no time. I'd like to keep my glove out of the water. I'm gonna let go, and there it goes.
Canadian Sport Fishing is brought to you by Suffix. Always use the best line. Yamaha, conquer outdoors. Defend products, eco-friendly protection from biting insects. Dickies, quality workwear since 1922.
Center pins are ideal because it really helps you to make a natural presentation when you're drifting downstream. So I'm just gonna pick up this line and I'm gonna make a cast right on the current break and I'll show you how it works. First of all, they're 1-to-1 gear ratio. They're very smooth. So to cast out, I'm just gonna very gently cast it out and I'm gonna let it get to the right depth, which is right there. And I'm just gonna hold on to it. One of the reasons why steelheaders like to use these drift rods is when they're using a float like this, it'll actually make your drift perfect because the current will engage the reel and it'll drift at the same speed as the current, so you don't have to constantly let line out like with a spinning outfit. Then when you hook a fish, there's no drag on these, so your hands or your fingers are the drag.